गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे टॉपिक इज एव्स, जनरल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ एव्स। ओके, जनरल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ एव्स। वी नो अबाउट द एव्स। एक्चुअली यू हैव टू सम टेक वन इन बर्ड। Eaves is nothing but birds. Okay, you have to take your parrot, any kind of. Okay, మనం చెప్పుకుంటాం కదా, పావురం అనుకుంటాం, కాకి అనుకుంటాం, కోయిలు అనుకుంటాం, ఇవన్నీ మనకు ఆకాశంలో ఎగురుతున్నటువంటి పక్షులు అయితే ఉన్నాయో, దోస్ ఆర్ ఏరియల్ లైఫ్ మోడ్ ఆఫ్ సూటెడ్ టు మోడ్ ఆఫ్ ఏరియల్ లైఫ్ ద కాల్ యాజ్ ఏ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది కాల్ యాజ్ ఏ బర్డ్స్. ఓకే, ది స్టడీ ఆఫ్ ది బర్డ్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్ యాజ్ ఏ ఆర్నిథాలజీ. Okay, the bird body is highly suited for to aerial mode of life. Okay, now come to part of the distinct characters. అంటే స్పెషల్గా ఉన్నటువంటి డిస్టింక్ట్ క్యారెక్టర్స్. ఓకే, దీస్ ఆర్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ వామ్ బ్లడెడ్ ఎనిమల్స్. వాట్ మీన్స్ వామ్ బ్లడెడ్ ఎనిమల్స్? There are the two types of animals is there, cold blooded animals and the warm blooded animals. Cold blooded animals, if any changes in the environment, the body temperature also change. Some of the animals, if body in atmosphere, in environment, it will be changes, the body temperature also will change. That type of animals is called as cold blooded animals. Okay, some animals, if there is no relationship and there is no coordination about the environment, if environment changes, the body temperature will be never changes. That type of animals is called as a warm blooded animals. For example, here human beings and the mammals as like birds are the almostly warm blood animals. If any environment changes, if temperature will be changing, the environment changes in the environment changes, there is no changes, the body temperature will be never changes. Okay, and that type of is called as a warm blood animals. Okay, now come to here, body covered with feathers, which is called as a exoskeleton. Now, body divisible into head and trunk and the tail. Head, trunk and tail. Here, the head contain one pair of eyes. Okay, and the beak, a strong beak. And the mouth. Okay, and the trunk containing two pairs of pentadactylic limbs. And the last one is part is the tail. Okay, here jaws are absent. Okay, here jaws are absent. Jaws are absent, and the teeth are also, sorry, the jaws are absent, which is modified as strong beak. Mukuga maripadam jarugutundi. Okay, and the teeth also absent. Teeth also extinct, and the tail is short, and the prevalent width here tail is short. It is a short and provided with feathers. Provided with the feather. These are the body. Okay. Now come to here. Two pairs of pentadactyly. Pentadactyl limbs. Two pairs and jabkuna gama. One pair is a forelimb. Forelimb. Second one is the hind limb. Forelimb will be modified as a wings. Recall your marpani. Which helps to flight. Flying. Flight. Okay. Now come to second one, hind limbs, which are useful for the walking and the perching and the posture and the swimming. These are very strongly compared with forelimbs. Okay. And now come here, general characters of apes. The distinct characters of the birds are warm-blooded animals. Okay. Body covered with feathers. This is called as an exoskeleton. Body containing are divisible into three parts: head, trunk, and tail. And the body is divisible into three: head, trunk, tail. Okay. One pair of eyes and the beak, mouth are present in the head. And the two pairs of pentadactyl limbs. Okay, there are the two pairs of pentadactyl limbs. One pair is the forelimbs, and second pair is the hind limb. Forelimb will be changes as a wings, and hind limb changes as is nothing but is strongly in the limbs. These are the useful for the walking and perching and swimming. These are the body. Now skin is without glass. The moist skin is almost look like as a dry skin. Apes skin is a very dry skin. There is no glands. Skin is without glands. But one gland is present, that is the preen gland. Preen gland or oil gland, which is present at the tail. It helps to the clean the tail. Okay, and the pectoral muscles, which are important muscles. Pectoral muscles are there, which helps to flying. Pectoral muscles are there, which helps to flying, and the bones are pneumatic. Bones are pneumatic. Those bones are filled with air, that is called as a pneumatic, which is also one of the flight adaptation, one of the character of the flight adaptations. And that's why the body of the bird is very light, because the bones are completely filled with the air. Okay. And the vertebrae is the heterocoelous. Here, heterocoelous. This type of heterocoelous. Actually, amphicoelous. This is the amphicoelous. And the procoelous. Vertebrae are different types. Here, different type of vertebrae is there, that is called as a heterocoelous. One of the important characters, synsacrum. The formation of synsacrum is a very important. Synsacrum. Okay. Synsacrum. Then there is a samyukta trikamantamu. Here, last thoracic vertebrae and the 6 lumbar vertebrae and the 2 sacral vertebrae and the 5 anterior
garden vertebrae. Completely 14.
Okay, so 7 plus 6.
Okay, these are the 5 plus 7, 7, 7 plus 6, 13. 30 plus this is the 1. And the 14 vertebrae. Okay, 14 vertebrae
are fused to form a compound bony structure that is called as a
sacrum. Okay, 14 vertebrae fused to form a bony structure that is called as a
sacrum, which is also one of the flight adaptation. It is very important to move the bird. Okay, and the posterior few
here anterior caudal vertebrae is over. Here come to posterior few caudal vertebrae. Caudal vertebrae
are form pygo style.
Pygo style.
And the ribs are double headed, and the sternum is large and broad. The sternum attached to the, some of the pectoral muscles are attached to the sternum, which is used to the flying. Okay, and the clavicle of the both of the sides unit to form a furcula, which is V-shaped furcula.
Okay, V-shaped furcula is formed.
And the come to, these are the internal characteristics of the birds. Okay, here we learn about the, we have to discuss about the pentadactylar limbs, hind limbs, fore limbs and hind limbs. Here the skin is without glands. Okay, skin is moisture, dry out, because the skin is covered with completely feathers. That's why there is no need of glands. Only one gland is present, that is the pineal gland, or nothing but eye gland, which is helps to the clean the tail. Ekkada toka bhagam untundi dani keelane maatrame akkada eye gland undi ini secretion anundi jarugutundi then vala eye gland vala. Okay, and the pectoral muscles are attached to the sternum, and to which is useful for the flying. It is one of the character of the flight adaptation. And the bones are rheumatic, it is for the, which those bones are completely filled with the air. That type of bones are called as the pneumatic bones, that is useful for the flying. And which helps the body light. And the vertebrae are heterocoelous. Okay, the vertebrae are different type of either. Here are the thoracic, lumbar and sacral, and the caudal vertebrae. There are four types of vertebrae are there. Here thoracic, lumbar and sacral, and the caudal vertebrae. Some of the in this I talk about the syncytium. Okay, the syncytium is modified. The syncytium is a modified. Syncytium is nothing but a bony like structure which form a 14 vertebrae. A compound of 14 vertebrae. What are the 14 compounds? 14 vertebrae here. Last thoracic vertebrae, and the 6 lumbar vertebrae, and the 2 sacral vertebrae, and the 5 anterior caudal vertebrae. Completely 14 vertebrae fused to form a compound of bony like structure that is called as a syncytium. It is also one of the major flight adaptation character. Okay, and the anterior caudal vertebrae is over. Some of the few posterior caudal vertebrae are also there. The few caudal vertebrae are also to form pygo style, and the V-shaped furcula is also there. And ribs are double headed. Ribs are double headed, and the sternum is large and broad. Pectoral muscles are attached to the sternum to use for the flying, and the clavicle of the both sides are unit to form furcula. The furcula is nothing but a V-shaped structure Okay, now come to system.
What are systems? Digestive system
here
preventiculars gizzard. These are opposite in the digestive system.
Alimentary canal is present.
Okay, what are the alimentary canal? Here mouth is opens to buccal cavity opens to pharynx. Pharynx opens to stomach opens to small intestine opens to large intestine opens to anus.
These are the digestive system. Okay,
and I come to respiratory system.
Respiratory system is very important too, because the birds or the aves are mainly flying in the aerial mode here. That's why they need to much more of oxygen. That's why respiration will be very important process in their body. That's why the lungs are very larger in size, and the 9 air sacs, some of the as done under Hanumanta Grandul
accessory respiratory organs. Accessory respiratory organs is nothing but air sacs. Okay, this is the respiratory system, and the lungs are spongy in nature, and the 9 air sacs are there. This is the air sacs are directly attached to the lungs.
Whenever oxygen comes from the outside to lungs, that will be
a double respiration process is occurring in the respiratory system. First of all, in the outside of the oxygen is outside here. When oxygen comes from the lungs, that is the one process. Where the lungs is spongy, the oxygen also, the lungs are spongy in nature, the contracted. That's why the oxygen of the lungs already having the oxygen. The lungs, whenever lungs are contracted, the oxygen is moved to air sacs as well as bones. This is the second respiration. So double respiration processes occur in the bird's respiration system. Because they are flying in mood, they need much more of oxygen is there. That's why they depends on their double respiration process.
Okay. And the
larynx in our body,
our sound box is nothing but larynx. But here, the bird's voice box is
syrinx.
This is one of the special box.
Larynx is present, but vocal hearts are absent. That's why they cannot release the sounds.
Okay, they cannot release the sounds. And they come to
circulatory system. Four-chambered heart is there.
That is a four-chamber means two auricles and two ventricles.
Options of the sinus venosus and the truncus arteriosus. Okay. Only right aortic arch is present.
I hear double respiration.
Double respiration, those containing in the pulmonary respiration and systemic respiration, they call as a double respiration process.
You know, mummy is also same thing is here. And the respiratory system
here, metanephric kidneys are present, which helps to the process the excretor system, and the excretor product is the uric acid. uric acid. Here one thing, urinary bladder is absent. That's why the release of the urine is spontaneously sudden. Okay, now come to respiratory system is over and digestive system is over and the circulatory system, and come to nervous system. Nervous system, okay. Optic lobes. The birds are aerial in life. They look like a much more of distance. That's why the optic lobes are well developed. You know, the example of course is this. Eagle. ఆకాశం ఎంత ఎత్తు ఎదురుతూ ఉంటుంది కింద ఉన్నటువంటి ఆబ్జెక్ట్ని ఈజీగా ఐడెంటిఫై చేస్తుంది బికాస్ దే ఆప్టిక్ లోబ్స్ ఆర్ వెల్ డెవలప్డ్ దట్స్ వై దే లుకింగ్ ఇస్ ఈజీ ఓకే అండ్ ట్వెల్వ్ పేర్స్ ఆఫ్ క్రేనియల్ నర్వ్స్ ట్వెల్వ్ పేర్స్ ఆఫ్ క్రేనియల్ నర్వ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ట్వెల్వ్ పేర్స్ ఆఫ్ క్రేనియల్ నర్వ్స్ అండ్ కమ్ టు హియర్ లాస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ద రిప్రొడక్టివ్ సిస్టమ్ హియర్ సెక్సెస్ ఆర్ సెపరేటెడ్ and the maintain the sexual dimorphism. Okay. The female bird and the male bird are different and the sexual dimorphism is clearly observed and the fertilization is internal fertilization the sperm directly injected to vaginal of the bird and the calcareous calcareous eggs are formed and the eggs are macrolecithal so the much more of yolk sac is present that's why the eggs are having the much more of yolk sac and the fetal membranes are present and the parental hair present in the some of the group parent what means when the parents caring the about the child that is called as a parental care and the fertilization internal and the sexual dimorphism and eggs are macrolecithal these are the here now come to here a brief structure compared to digestive system proventricular and gizzards are absent in the digestive system commonly alimentary canal is present that is the mouth opens to buccal cavity opens to pharynx opens to stomach small intestine and large intestine that will be outside of the body is the anus okay that is the alimentary canal that is nothing but is the digestive canal or digestive tract now respiratory system a spongy type of one pair of lungs is there and the nine air sacs the air sac is nothing but accessory respiratory organs okay it is completely filled with oxygen whenever the oxygen comes from the outside to lungs the when lungs are contracted the air will be forcible move to from lungs to bones as well as air sacs so the process of the respiration system is the double because the birds suited to aerial life that's why they need to much more of oxygen that's why the respiratory process will be very increasing in their life now come to circulatory system in respiratory system larynx is also present as well as but it is not a voice box of the body is the syrinx is a it is a one of the voice box it is a special box which is releases the some sounds and the larynx does not have the vocal heart that's why they cannot release the voice and the circulatory system the heart having the four chambered the two auricles and the as well as two ventricles there is no sinus venosus and the as well as truncus arteriosus only right side of the right aortic arch systemic arches will be bifurcated into two left and right okay so here right side of the aortic arches will be only present the left side of the aortic arches is absent okay and the excretory system one pair of kidney is there the kidneys are belongs to metanephric kidneys and the urinary bladder is absent and the excretory product is the uric acid and come to nervous system is the optic lobes are well developed because the bird is identify the object in the earth along with a long distance
That's why the optic lobes are well developed, which is recognize the object in the a much more of distance. So 12 pairs of cranials are there, and the last one, the reproductive system, sexes are separate and sexes are dimorphism, and the fertilization is internal, directly sperm is internally injected to the worms, and the calcareous eggs are laid. The eggs is form eggs is macrolystal type of eggs, because the yolk sac is a highly amount of yolk sac is present. That's why it is a macrolystal, and the fetal membrane is also present, and the parental care in the parental care is present in the some of the groups. So what means of parental group? Parental care. Parental care is nothing but parents caring their children. That type, that process is called as a parental care. It is well developed in the amphibians. In some, in birds also, some maintain the parental. మనం అబ్జర్వ్ చేయొచ్చు. ఇక్కడ ఇంటి దగ్గర ఉన్నటువంటి చిన్న చిన్న కోళ్ళు కానీ బాతులు కానీ ఇవన్నీ కూడా బర్డ్స్ కిందకి వస్తాయి కదమ్మా. అవి ఎట్లుంటాయి, అవి చూస్తుంటాం కదా. అంటే ఒక కోడి తన తల్లి ఉన్నానుకో పిల్లల్ని ఇక్కడ కూడా ప్రొటెక్ట్ చేస్తూ ఉంటుంది. గద్దె కానీ కాకర వచ్చిన పిల్లి నుంచి ప్రొటెక్ట్ చేస్తూ ఉంటుంది. దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ దట్ ఈస్ ద పేరెంటల్ కేర్. పేరెంటల్ కేర్, దిస్ ఈస్ ద జనరల్ క్యారెక్టర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏవ్స్, నథింగ్ బట్ బర్డ్స్. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ.